वेलकम बैक टू माय इंग्लिश लर्निंग यूट्यूब चैनल माय डियर सब्सक्राइबर्स एंड व्यूअर्स आई एम डिस्कसिंग वॉइस इन माय वीडियोस सो ऑल ऑफ यू नो दैट वॉइस इज ऑफ टू काइंड्स दैट इज एक्टिव वॉइस एंड पैसिव वॉइस आई हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस्ड दिस टू काइंड्स ऑफ वॉइस इन माय प्रीवियस वीडियो सो आई विल डिस्कस वॉइस इन दिस प्रेजेंट वीडियो ऑल्सो सो हाउ active voice sentence is changed into passive voice sentence I have already given all the rules I have already given all the rules for changing voice from active to passive so today we'll practice all the tenses all the tenses in step by step today we will discuss all the tenses step by step regarding the change of voice okay from active to passive or passive to active so here I am going to start present indefinite tense how the change how the passive voice of present indefinite tense is done from active okay we have already learned tenses there are 12 kind of tenses and all 12 kinds of tenses may be changed into passive voice so here You can see that I am writing number one A present indefinite tense, present indefinite or simple present tense. I will try to explain every tense with structure of active and passive present indefinite tense. So if we want to write a sentence of present indefinite tense in active voice, it will be subject. Then main verb, then object. Okay, and if there is something else or some other words, then we write it as an extension. Okay, so here I am writing the structure of active voice of present indefinite tense. All of you know that this is the structure of present indefinite tense. This one is subject, and this is main verb. It is in present tense. And this is an object. So, I am writing an example here. You will see, and it is very easy if we get by heart the structure and also try to understand. Okay. So there will be a revision of tenses also along with the voices. So here I am writing. I play cricket. Okay, I play cricket every day. I play cricket every day. So here I have written this sentence as subject, main verb. Then cricket is an object. Okay, and every day it is an extension. So it is the sentence of active voice. And if we want to change it into passive, then how should we change it? So please remember, this subject is number one. This subject is number one, and this object is number two. I am identifying subject as number one and object as number two. Why I am identifying? You will know it a little later. Very soon, you will know it very soon. Now I am writing here the structure of passive voice. So you see. Here I am writing subject, but remember it. This subject is not the subject here because we have already learned from the rules of voice that object must be made subject. Okay, object must be made subject. So this object has come here, and we have used it as subject because we start a sentence with a subject only. Okay. That is why we have written it here. Subject, not object. But you must remember, this subject is not written here, but this object is written here as a subject. That is why, just before I told you why I have numbered this subject as one and object as two. You will understand it right now. Now I will write here two. It means this object has come here and its name has become a subject. okay, this one has not come here, but this two has come here. Okay, I hope you have already understood, and it is very easy. And all those who get difficulty in learning voice sense, they will definitely learn it very easily. I hope so. Okay, so observe what I am doing here. Observe carefully what I am doing here. So here I have written two. That means this object has become here a subject. So now, as the tense is a present living tense, so a verb will come, and the verb of present tense is am, is, or are. Okay, all these three form will come, and it will be applicable according to the subject. Okay, now this is one of the greatest characteristics of passive voice, that we always, the past participle form of the main verb. We always use the past participle form of the main verb. So this will be PP. Okay, I have written here in short form. PP means past participle form of the main verb. With what the main verb here is, we must use the past participle or third form of the main verb. We can write like this. This is verb 3. Okay, present tense, past tense, and past participle, or verb 1, verb 2, or verb 3. That means verb 3 means past participle. Okay, then we use by. In most cases, by comes, then plus object. So remember here again, this object is not the object here. Now this subject has become, this subject has become object. That is why we will write here 1. Okay, that means that this number 1 has come here. Now its name has become object. Okay, I hope the idea is very clear. The idea is very clear, and you have already understood. So now we'll practice this sentence here. This one is subject, this one is verb, and here it is an object. Every day is an extension. Now, according to the rule of the passive voice, object must be made subject. That is why I have written here subject as number 2. That means this object. That means cricket will come at the very beginning of the sentence. So this sentence, this implies cricket. Okay, cricket will come. And as it is a sentence of present indefinite tense, so I am, is, or are will come. So with cricket, the verb is will come. Okay, cricket is. Again, we have to use the past participle form of verb 3 of the main verb. That is why we have to write play, played, played. Okay, we have to write play, played, and play. Then this by. Okay, by will come. So cricket is played by. The subject here is I. It will be me. Okay, it will be me. The object of I is me, and every day will remain the same. It will be every day only. Okay, I hope you have already understood the sentence. This is A, active voice, AB, and this one is PB. Okay, passive voice. So I hope you have already understood what I have told you. Very easy method to change from active to passive. Now I want to give one more information regarding the subject and object form of the pronoun. One example is enough to understand, because everything has become crystal clear here, that how a sentence of active voice is changed into a sentence of passive voice. These two structures tell everything us. Okay, now sometimes our students get difficulty in the form of subject and object, or in the subject and object forms of the pronoun. See, here I am writing subject and object. Okay, object. So if the subject is I, its object will be me. Subject I, its object will be me. Again we, it will be us. Again you will remain the same, both in subject and object. You Then it is he will become him. It is she will become her. Then it is they. Okay, they will become they, them in object. Now if there is a noun, Noun never changes into anything. It remains the same both in subject and as an object. Okay, remember it. A noun never changes. The form of noun never changes as subject or object. It remains the same both in subject and object also. So here, if I write here, Ram, the boy, etc., we may not finish all the nouns and pronouns by writing here. So I have written here, etc., Ram, the boy, uncountable, unlimited nouns are there. That is why Ram, the boy, etc. I have written here. So in object form, it will be Ram only, the boy, etc. Whatever noun comes, that noun will remain the same in object form also. So I hope the rule is very simple and important to understand voice sense. Okay? Here I am again telling you, I, me, we, us, you, he, him, she, her, they, them, any noun remains the same, noun remains as the same. That means Ram, Hori, Jodo, Modu, and any person, anything, this duster, this pen, okay, everything will remain the same, both as subject and object. So you have already known it, the subject form and object form of the pronouns, and how a sentence of present indefinite tense changed into passive voice. Okay, here I am writing one more example. You can see here that boy helps the poor man. Okay, that boy helps the poor man. So this is a sentence of present indefinite tense. Here it is subject, this one is verb, the poor man, it is an object here. So it is the sentence of active voice. That is why I have written here AV, active voice. Okay. So now what we should do to make it passive? It is very easy. That object will become the subject. This one is one, this one is one, this one is two. So two will come here to become a subject. The poor man will come here, the poor man. Okay, and the verb is in present tense. That is why poor man will take is, the poor man is. Then we must use the past participle form of the main verb. So it will be helped. Then we have to use by, the preposition by will come. Okay, then we have to write the subject here as an object. The subject here is that boy. It is a noun, so no change will take place here. That is why it will be that boy. So I hope it will be a sentence of passive voice. So I hope you have already understood what I have explained here. So we'll proceed further in our next videos. And the chapter is a long one. We'll discuss every pros and cons of this chapter voice, and it is very important for all the students and also for every person who wants to know English grammar and wants to know the use of voice when speaking and writing also. So I want to finish this video here today. So thank you for watching my video.